Hello viewers, today I am going to discuss outcome-based academic research model to accomplish higher cognitive levels and program outcome attainment in the learners. What is outcome-based academic research model? We all know outcome-based education, OBE model, which is quite matured now. So by taking the reference of that, I have designed a new model which is outcome-based academic research. In Hindi, we have a proverb, Ek pan do kaaj. This model is similar to that. Here we are addressing three issues simultaneously. This model helps us to achieve higher PO attainment, higher cognitive levels as per the revised Bloom's taxonomy, and you can measure knowledge, skill and attitude of your learners and even give input for improvement of the same. Now why to do a research? Now there are two different perspectives of doing research. In academic institution, the teaching, learning, academic activities are considered as most important activity, and another activities are slightly treated as a secondary activity. From the faculty and student perspective, the research can be doing a PhD for acquiring the next level of promotion, or might be winning some competition at national level. But as an institute, the goal of the research is slightly different. All the institutions now want very good quality of publication, because through that they can improve their NIRF ranking, and which helps them in achieving the accreditation as well as branding of the institute. Now there is a gap between the expectations of the stakeholder. How to fill the gap? All of us, we know the example of ship dipping with the caisson. Similarly, here in OBAR also, we are not forcing learner or the teachers to do a research, but we are providing a path by which easily, along with their teaching learning process, they can do a research. What is exactly outcome-based academic research model? Outcome-based academic research starts at the goal and it works backward. So you have to set the research goal first, what you want to do as a part of your academic delivery. Then according to that, we can design the assignments and select the topic from the syllabus. So now let us see how this particular incremental process is linking one step to another. As a faculty, every semester we get a subject of our choice. After getting the subject, let us decide that in that semester, what is my research goal? I might want to publish a very good quality research paper. That could be a research goal. Second research goal could be I will apply for a grant with some innovative idea. Or some teacher can think that I will file a patent or do a consultancy for the industry. There could be one or multiple research goals decided by the faculty and the group of the students. Now this is standard OBE model. Whenever we get a subject, we design theory, practical, tutorial throughout the semester. The subject has 6 COs. It is mapped with the POs, which are derived from the graduate attributes. Even the COs are mapped to PSO, program specific outcome. All of them, they map or converge towards the department program educational objectives, which are mapping or converging towards the institute mission keywords, and the mission helps institute to achieve the vision. That means as a faculty, if I am taking one particular subject, I am helping my institute to achieve the vision. one particular component which is missed out in this whole journey is assignment. So OBAR recommends to give assignment to the students which has an enrichment activity within it, which has a research component in it. So whenever students are doing the assignment, we are indirectly getting our research goal accomplished. So let us see how we can do it. So let us take one subject of your choice. I am taking the example of Green IT, elective subject of third year. Subject has 6 modules and 6 course objectives. I have shown you in the previous slide. The skill attitude components are not at all mapped by the selected subject. Let us see the strength of OBAR model. Out of the syllabus, let us take one module and a subtopic multi-threading. There are 2 learning objectives, as you can see on the slide, for the topic multi-threading. Now this slide shows that these are the theory points which are given inside the textbook, and as a faculty through PPT or might be some kind of video, I am explaining it to the student. After the topic is explained, what I am doing, I am taking the measurement or the mapping of the topic along with the POs and Bloom's taxonomy label. You can see that LO1 is mapped to understand and PO1, LO2 is mapped to PO2 and understand. Once I complete the topic, I am recommending to design one assignment question which is based on OBAR. What could be the question? For the multi-threading topic, you can ask a question like, analyze performance of CPU and GPU for multi-threading processing. Now GPU was not part of the syllabus, but still students will start searching and comparing the performance. This particular question mapped to PO3, PO4 and PO5 and at the higher RBT level. Second part of the question can be, create a code in Java, or might be they can use their existing code and execute that code with different threads. So in that they can actually develop lots of peripheral learning, and it is on the still higher level of Bloom's taxonomy. You can see this is a digital taxonomy and it is very much helpful now for the 21st century learners. So instead of just having their journals or the practical students, we are encouraging them for the higher order thinking skills. What is the outcome expected out of the assignment question? So there are 2 outcomes which I have expected as a faculty, that student might prepare a good poster and participate in the competition and share their learning. And along with the student as a faculty, I can develop a paper. So you can see that students have developed very good colorful poster here, where they are showing their own developed code and the comparison with 4, 8 and 12 thread, how the power consumption is affected. So nothing is given there in the textbook or the lab practical list of the sessions, but students have developed this particular knowledge. Now after assignment, if you do LOCOPO mapping again, we can see that higher level of POs have started attempted and the RBT levels are also higher. Let us take one more example quickly. This is a vectorization example where you have to remove the for loops and you have to increase the performance of the processor, which is a base of high performance computing. So similarly, students were given the assignment and we can see that here also higher order of learning outcomes, POs and the RBT labels are taken by the students. here this particular group, they have presented their research paper into the conference, now which is recommended further for the Scopus journal. After implementing OBAR framework to the subject in the all modules and the respective topics, you can see that now COPO attainment has improved. There are few more POs which I can attend on the higher side, few on the medium side. And those who were initially on the medium side, now they have changed to even the higher level. This is mathematically proved with the results of the students. This particular slide shows the comparison of the PO1, PO2, PO3 attainment after term test 1 for last 3 years. Here you can see that the PO attainment have improved, and especially the skill component have improved a lot, and after adding assignment we can see the further improvement. So what is actually the outcome of outcome based academic research model? That lots of peripheral knowledge is created, KSA is developed with the higher RBT level, good quality research papers can be produced along with your teaching without putting much of the additional effort, because OBAR recommends that whenever you design any assignment question and give it to student, give that question into the group of 8 to 10 students and take only one copy, so you actually are correcting 10 master copies. Once you give correction, everything is okay on your side, the students can file the same copy for the group. You can even apply for grants and consultancy through the innovative idea from the students and your own efforts. So OBAR helps us to building a bridge to success. Any one of you, if you want to implement for your own subject this particular concept, design innovative assignments for the student, you can contact me on the given details. I am thankful to Ajay Bhagwat sir and Input Solutions for giving this opportunity to share my thoughts, which is in line with NEP 2020 and outcome based education. So let us all produce 21st century learners from our campus. Thank you.